WP. Miss. Yan. WP.
Mula sa inyong kamat ay Magda Kaglawang Candy. Mona Isa, I'm sorry. Mona Isa Yu Kamat. The state citation will be given to Mona Isa Yu Kamat in grateful recognition of her exemplary academic performance as a Bangsamoro Scholar of the Access to Higher Modern Education Scholarship Program. Another award will also be given to Jawayuia Kitokala, a Magna Magna Cum Laude candidate from Lanao del Sur.
Papunta ko dito para magpa sila, para may space pa. Mabog.
A plaque of recognition again to be awarded to Jawayuia D. Ditokalan, a Magna Cum Laude candidate, in grateful recognition of her exemplary academic performance as a Bangsamoro Scholar on the Access to Higher and Modern Education Scholarship Program of ACME SP. Congratulations. Yung ito po natin yung mga awardees, we will be calling their attention later. Again, ito po ang ating summa cum laude and magna cum laude ng ating ACME SP of the Bangsamoro Autonomous Region in Pacific Kingdom. Thank you very much. Gathered in deep respect, we eagerly await the words of a leader whose love for the Bangsamoro region knows no bounds. Let us warmly welcome the Chief Minister of the Bangsamoro region, Ahod Ahad Murad Ibrahim, the Chief Minister, as he shares his message with us.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah wa bihi nasta'in. Wassalatu wassalamu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. First and foremost, I congratulate our brother Minister Mahathir Iqbal for his for this very successful program. Thank you very much. Alam niyo, ngayon ko lang na-confirm yung AHME na yung initial ko pala nung nasa struggle na sa jihad ako. That is my initial. No patis ako, I was already suspecting, sabi ko, ano ito, coincidental na ito ang naging mga. Pero later on, na-realize ko, sabi ko, may nag-plano dito. So, thank you very much sa inyong lahat. First, itong scholarship program to us is very important. Kasi kami mismo, kung hindi sa scholarship, siguro hindi namin marating kung ano yung narating namin sa educational part. Early on, kasi later, I was Anthony and Opal. My mother died when I was still 3 years old. My father died when I was first year high school. So I was left to my brother for my livelihood and education, our eldest brother. Pero sa alam niyo yung family circle is also what hindi so hindi rin naman what sabihin natin na ordinary lang yung life namin. So when I graduated high school, magkasama kami nito si Minister Iqbal. We graduated together in the Cotabato Public High School. Kasi kailang nasa Section 1 siya, ako nasa Section 2 lang. So, nung mag-graduate kami, I was wondering also how I can proceed with my college education. Kasi yun na nga, ang nagbibigay lang sa akin ng bala is yung eldest brother namin. So I was wondering how to pa. Then fortunately, we took an examination sa Mindanao State University, MSU. So, magkasama rin kami nag-take ng examination ni Minister Iqbal. And then we both passed the scholarship. Nakapasa kami sa scholarship. So, nagkasuso kami na we will study together in MSU. So, nung opening na lang iskulan ng bar, I was wondering, saan si Brother Iqbal na, I was marami, sabi ko, bakit hindi nakarating si Brother Iqbal? So, I tried to reach to him, sabi niya, nandito ko sa Manila, kasi nakuha ko yung CN, CIA, Commission on National CNI, CNI Scholarship. So sabi niya, dito na ako magkara. So ikaw na lang dyan sa MSU. So I studied in the Mindanao State University for my first year in engineering, civil engineering. So in the following year, I was able to get also my CNI scholarship. Nag-operate yung CNI. Kasi itong CNI scholarship, it is a scholarship intended for the minority Muslims in the Philippines. Commission on National Integration. So, dahil nakuha ko yung then he was inviting me to follow him in Manila. Sabi ko, hindi na ka malikman itong kwan, dito na sa Cotabato. So I enrolled in Notre Dame University. So dyan ako in studying engineering. Then, unfortunately, in my fifth year as a civil engineering student, ay ang kadaon na tumating yung tawag ng higher requirement na mayroong military training. So I was recruited by our leaders. Sabi na, sumali ka dito. Sabi ko, paano yung pag-aaral mo? I'm already graduating. Sabi nila, huwag mo na lang pansin niya. Posible pa rin ito. So, I left school and then joined the struggle. So, yun ang konting background ng buhay, buhay ko at buhay namin ni Brother Edward. So, ngayon, when we are now in the bar, pinag-usapan namin kung ano yung magiging priority natin sa bar. So, unang-una na napagkasunduan namin is education ang unang-unang priority. Kasi we realize na very important yung education. At very nakita rin natin na yung education is talagang kailangan ng ating mga bangsa mo. So kaya yun ang unang priority na i-declare namin. Well, tayo apat ang priority na na-declare. Una ang education, pangalawa is medical and health, then infrastructure, at pang-apat yung education, medical and health, and then infrastructure, social services. Social services. So yun ang apat na officially declared na priority program ng Bangsa Moro Tumono sa Union Muslim Mindanao na itinataguyod natin ngayon. So yan ang So, kayo, you are very very fun na maswerte kayo na ngayon nabigyan kayo ng scholarship more than 1,000 na itong mga estudyante. We hope na itong kayo ngayon ang magiging hope ng ating Bangsa Moro at ang ating Bangsa Moro Bunga. So, yun ang mga. So, let me read to you my prepared message. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. And good morning. At the outset, I wish to convey my heartfelt congratulations to you and your family, as you will all be graduating this coming May of the current academic year, inshallah. Congratulations, senyor. I am humbled to feel on this historic occasion and celebrate the journey of 1,400 students from the first cohort of access to higher and broader education, or Al-Haji Murad Ibrahim Scholars. This event is a testament to our mission of producing a Bangsa Moro professionals from all areas of the autonomous region, from all the areas of the autonomous region in Muslim Mindanao. As you are all aware, the journey of the Bangsa Moro people for social justice, equal opportunities, and greater participation started very long a time ago when we were subject to the discrimination and oppression. That is why we have fought very hard to realize our aspiration of genuine and meaningful autonomy in the southern Philippines. Today, it gives me a great honor and pride that one of many byproducts of our jihad came to fruition, as we will produce 1,400 new Bangsa Moro professionals. Technical Education for training the path for this flagship program under the supervision of Minister Muhajir Iqbal. I also convey my gratitude to all those who compose the ministry. We stand by our promise to reform the system and give access to quality service for social justice, and every day we strive to make an effective use of this promise, and return every investment we make to the Bangsamoro people. But let us be reminded that our work is far from over. As our region still has the lowest literacy rate in the country, and we need every bit of help to ensure that our dreams for our homeland will be fully realized. To the scholars, your story is the narrative of every Bangsamoro. Your journey is also our journey, and you are the very definition of a Bangsamoro patuloy na nagsusumikap para sa isang mapayapa at magandang kinabukasan, inshallah. We may be tested by time, but the resilience of the Bangsamoro is something that we look up to and something that we must be proud of. And by seeing your faces today and hearing your inspiring stories, I am confident that the future of our beloved Bangsamoro is in good hands, inshallah. Kaya sa patuloy ninyong pagtalakay, ang pamahalaan ng Bangsamoro ay patuloy na susuporta sa inyong mga pangarap. Continue to preserve, dream, and aim high. Continue to become the very best definition of a Bangsamoro to inspire us and the future of the Bangsamoro. Na may pagbalayin kayo ng Allah, pagbalayin ng Bangsamoro, at sa hinaharap, pagkakapit natin ang inaasam-asam at nahihinda progreso, kapayapaan at magandang buhay dito sa Bangsamoro. So, we challenge you to work hard in order to achieve our dream for the Bangsamoro. So thank you very much. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Thank you to our Chief Minister of the Bangsamoro Autonomous Region in Masjid Mindanao for your unwavering dedication to improving education and prosperity in the region. And napakagandang istorya din po from the Chief Minister and the Minister who were also once and scholars like you. So palakpakan ulit natin Chief Minister Arun Ahmad Murad Ibrahim. Before we continue our program, let us